Welcome back to Mapping for Quake with TrenchBroom. This episode, we're covering trains. Now, trains are just moving brushes, basically. A funk train is a brush or a group of brushes that move along a specific path, and you control those path with path corners, which are entities that you place in the level. So there's the path corner. I'm gonna make one in a few minutes, but let's look at some examples of what you can do with trains. A really great example is Mukor's map from Retro Jam 6. And he's got this amazing bridge that kind of transforms itself and gets you to the final teleporter. I kind of cheated through the level to just get this footage here. So normally the teleporter would be up higher, but this is really a fantastic use of trains. It's kind of the most extreme example I could find. A more simple version is in episode 1, map 5, these spikes are actually trains and they have a damage. It's kind of an obstacle course to run through here. In episode 2, map 5 of Quake, which is the Wizard's Manse, there's this really crazy one that goes underwater and kind of traps you, and you're moving along this path and it's kind of nerve-wracking. At the very last minute, you kind of rise up out of the water. So first, we're going to make a very simple train, and then we'll go to a little bit more complicated setups after that. So we're in a simple little box map I've made for this, and I've made a brush that's going to act as our funk train. I'm going to right-click, go to Brush Entity, Funk, and Train, and now it's a brush entity. Okay, the next step is our path corner. So I'm going to drag a path corner into the map and take note of the key values here. We have our class name, obviously, origin. We have spawn flags. You have a target and a target name. So we're going to call this one path 1. Now I'm going to set up the target as path 2. And I'll go ahead and copy this guy. And let's swap these names. This guy, his name is path 1, he's targeting path 2, and then we need the exact opposite here. So let's change this to 2. It will target path 1. So now this path 1 targets path 2, path 2 targets path 1, and it's gonna go just back and forth. So those are the path corners. And then your funk train, let's take a look at the key values here. We have your class name, you have damage. So if the train kind of collides with the player and kind of forces them up against a wall or another surface, it's going to cause 2 damage every second. The sounds are set to 1. There's silent is 0 and ratchet metal is 1. The speed is 64. Now, here's the important thing. We need to target one of these two paths. We'll just start with path 1. But you can target whatever. And as long as these two are linked, it'll travel between those. So it really doesn't matter where you put this train. You have to concern yourself with the lighting of it, but we're gonna get to that later. So right now I just wanted to kind of display that this train is way over here, but when the map starts, it's gonna spawn right at this corner. So here's our simple little train here. It's just going back and forth, super boring. So off camera, the first time I compiled this, I made a little mistake and I wanna share this with you. These path corners were pretty close to the ground. In fact, they were on the ground. And what happens is, this is literally the corner of the brush entity. So it was too low. So you wanna give yourself some room, especially if you're kind of working with towards the bottom of the level. A lot of time these funk trains are suspended in midair and all that stuff, but it's good to know if your paths are really close to the bottom of the level or another piece of geometry, let's say another brush, you gotta give yourself a little bit of clearance here. So let's take a look at where this thing specifically spawns. So down here in the compass, you want the green arrow, which is signifies the Y axis. You want that pointing up, so at 90 degrees, so 90 is up. So I'm gonna kind of move this into position of where it will spawn into the map. So this is where the 2D views actually do come in handy for aligning things precisely. The lower left-hand corner is where the path corner should be. And if we kind of zoom in, you can see it's intersecting the corner. That's why it's called a path corner. So let's go to the 2D views and we have lower left, lower left, lower left. So now you can be sure that is where that is going to spawn. So I'm going to move this closer to the wall here. Just get this all the way over. So you can see how that positioning works when you're aligning things in the editor. So let's take a look at a little map I made to kind of show you a few more different styles and aspects of trains. All right, so we start off in this little tiny area with this kind of spiky trap thing that you've got to kind of avoid. And if you don't, you do that. So let's walk out of here. It's a little laggy when I record these, so it kind of messes me up a little bit. All right, so the first train I want to show you in this sample map is triggered. So it's just sitting here waiting for me, and then when I step on it, it's going to start going. So as you're traveling along this path, you've got the option of going over here or going up on this platform. So I'll go ahead and kind of get this nail gun. Got some scrags here that attacked me. Come on. So I'm going to drop down on this guy and get this armor here. Now the fatal flaw with this is you have to kind of wait. And I'm going to show you, you know, because now I've missed this guy and I don't want to go in the lava. So I've got to wait a little bit. And I'm going to fix that by adding another train to this this pathway. You can have as many as you'd like. Oops, hello. Now we're going to go up vertical and we're going to go across this area. And the idea is to kind of jump off here and catch this guy. Whoops, I'm going to die. There we go. Catch this one here that goes up and down. It's a vertical only. And I'll get the key and I'll be able to exit the level now. So just a simple little level. I've got a link to this down below along with the WAD file that I used. But now let's take a look and see how I created some of this stuff. As I said before, this one is triggered, but these guys aren't. This guy, as soon as the level starts, he just goes back and forth, and it's same with this guy as well. And also same with the trap. This funk train has a target name of train one, and the trigger has a target of train one. I made the paths here. This is the path that they follow. This is path one, this is path two, path three, sorry, path three. Path four, it goes vertically. Path five, it'll go to path six. And one thing I want to point out about this sixth path is that it kind of arrive, it goes back to this on a diagonal. You can have trains move on a diagonal. So as you can see, path six, target name path six, is targeting path one, and that closes the loop. So in the simple example, it was only two path corners, but you can have as many as you need. They can be vertical, horizontal, or, you know, travel at angles. It's however you want to do it. So these path corners have a wait key. And you can see this is wait one, and that's just 1 second. So it's going to each of these corners. And I think most of these are 1 second, but I wanted to pause here a little longer. So I made the wait 2.5 seconds. And so each of them can have their own wait key. And if you wanted to stop, let's say we wanted to just stop it up here and that was it and not travel on to, you know, the original destination, I could make this negative one. That was 2.5 seconds. 1 second. And now this stops. Down here with the armor, these are just two path corners, again, that just travel between each other. And this guy goes back and forth. We have this train that travels vertically by itself. And again, this is a closed loop right here of just two path corners. So I made this into a trap. This is a funk train. These are the two path corners. And as you can tell, this thing's not really in position. It's not kind of where it belongs. It would spawn into the level like this. But I want to show you why I did this. I wanted the brush to be lit a certain way. And so I have this lava. These lava lights are very subtle, but they're in there. When you play the level, you can see that this very faint lava glow on this brush. Also, the light coming from above is shining down on this. And this is important to note. Wherever this lives in the level, that's the light that the brush is going to exhibit once you compile and play the map. Along those lines, this one was kind of tricky because I was trying to get the right lighting. It was too dark in some cases and too light, so I kind of just split the difference and I actually added a little bit of a detail light to it. So it is something to think about where you're gonna do it. A lot of times if you just kind of get it close to where it's gonna live, the lighting will be good enough or right on the money. It just depends. getting back to this spike trap. So here's the funk train. It has a speed of 256. So that's quite a bit faster than our simple example. And he's just going back and forth really fast. And I made the damage 200. So if the player gets trapped, like I did in the playthrough, it's going to cause instantly 200 damage and totally gib the player. You can see this example from one of the original id maps. And that's a train. It's just traveling back and forth, and it's an obstacle and a trap for the player. So there's one last thing I want to do to this level. The way things work now is that you kind of get stuck over here for a while if you don't catch the train, so to speak. So I'm going to add another train. So I've actually added it already to the map. I made a copy of this guy down here, and it also has the target name of train one, which means this is going to start this going. I need to take this and set this back to 1 second because I almost forgot to do that. So now it won't stop up there. But the important thing is I'm going to target this path corner instead of the first one for obvious reasons. If they're both targeting the first one, they're both going to be kind of superimposed over each other over here. So we need to target this. This one has to have the target name of path four, which is right here. This guy is path four. So let's hit this. I can kind of get a glimpse of it over there. There it is. So that is our train tutorial, and hopefully you'll come up with some much better ideas than we have in this map. I mean, this is just a real basic stuff, but now you know how to do trains. So thanks for hanging in there, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.